Hello guys, and welcome back to a new video here at Architects 3DP. Today I'm going to review a new 3D printer that Artillery sent a couple weeks ago. And as you can see, it is the Artillery Genius Pro. If we have a look inside, we can see that the printer comes very well packed with protective foam that prevents any possible damage during shipping. The first we can find inside is a small spool of black PLA filament, some paperwork that looks like the instructions, more paperwork, some metallic parts here that look like the filament spool holder, and directly underneath, we can find an artillery bag that looks like it's full of tools, and we'll have a look at later on. When we remove the first layer of protective foam, underneath we can find the power cable, in my case with the EU plug, and right below the frame of the printer. Let me turn it so you can watch it better. As you can see, this is the X and Z axis that comes assembled. We're going to take it out of the box and put it on one side so we can continue with the unboxing. Finally, at the bottom of the box, we can find the base with the Y axis of the printer, that is pretty heavy, by the way. So in summary, we have from one side the base of the printer that contains the Y axis, next the X and Z axis, and finally all the other components and tools that came with it. Having a look at the tool bag, we can find two plastic rollers that I guess are for the spool holder, a USB-A to USB-B cable that, by the way, is pretty short, about 40 or 50 centimeters. Next, we find the spare flat cable in case one of the axis cables break. I remember that the Focus Odin 5 F3 3D printer that we reviewed a while ago used the same type of flat cables, and Focus also included a spare one. But the truth is that I've been using this 3D printer a lot because I'm very happy of how reliable it is, and for now the cables have never broke and it's been working perfectly. Next we can find a wrench and a plastic bag that contains a USB drive, a couple spare wheels, and a spare nozzle that is volcano-like. In the second plastic bag we'll find some Allen keys, a spare Bowden tube for the direct drive extruder, a T-nut, and a screw. We're gonna put everything back in place, and I'm gonna continue with the rest of the components of the printer. I'm going to use the included instructions to put it together. So I'm going to start with the base of the printer, that by the way has a piece of paper on top of the heated bed that says "Do not remove before you finish assembly." We're going to do that, and we're going to start by removing all the protective adhesive tape that holds everything from moving. As you can see, all the cables are taped down, so we're going to release them. As you can see now, the Y axis is able to move perfectly. I'm going to put the base of the printer away, and I'm going to bring the X and Z axis that, as you can see, still have the protective foam. I'm going to take it out and remove all the protective tape and flip it around. As you can see, the printer has two Z axis motors, what is a good signal of quality. We'll need to remove those zip ties that are holding everything in place and preventing it from moving later on. But now we're going to bring back the base, since we'll need to align both parts for the assembly. We'll need to insert this PCB-like plug into the base just like so, and once we have both sides correctly inserted, we'll turn it around to screw the bolts in place. We'll need to insert two bolts on each side, and we'll use the provided Allen keys to tighten them all the way through. Alright, so that was one side, and here we go for the second one. As always, we'll insert them with our fingers and then tighten them with the Allen keys just like so. Now we're going to cut off the zip ties holding everything in place as I announced before, using a flush cutter. And we're going to turn it around one more time to finish tightening the bolts at the bottom. We will tighten them till the frame is perfectly robust. Once done, I'm going to bring the Z axis up a little bit so we'll have more space in between the nozzle and the heated bed. Now we're going to install the filament spool holder that, as you can see, comes in two metallic components, and one of them contains the filament detection sensor. According to the instructions, it seems to go right here on top. So we'll insert one side, then the other that has this small thumb screw, and finally we'll insert the plastic rollers that go right here, as you can see. It is not very stable, but it seems properly installed, so we'll see how it works later on. I'm now going to unwrap the included small spool of filament, and as you can see, it rolls pretty well on top of the filament spool holder. I imagine it will work even better with a bigger 1 kg spool. Now it's time to connect all the cables that are not connected from the factory. We're going to start with the right Z-axis motor, just like so. And here we have a cable connector that I don't really know what it is for, so we'll keep it unplugged for now. Now we'll jump to the other side of the printer, where we'll connect the Z-axis motor. But wait, what was that noise? I've turned the printer upside down and I discovered that maybe I'm too strong since the head of one of the bolts got completely wrecked, as you can see. I guess I turned it too hard, but I hope it will work just fine with only one bolt in place. Back to the Z-axis motor, we'll connect it in place just like so, and then we'll connect the Z-axis end stop that is right next to it. Next, we'll go to the top since we'll connect the filament runout detection sensor. Here we go.
Alright guys, so it seems that we have done all the necessary hardware and cable connections for the printer. According to the instructions, the last step will be to double check that all the wheels are properly tightened for all the axes. So that is what we're gonna do now.
Starting with the X-axis carriage, we'll make sure that all three bolts are properly tightened using the provided tools. As you can see, here we have it ready to go.
The bolts of the Y-axis of the carriage are not very accessible to tighten, but I have checked them with my fingers and it looks that everything is tight in place.
Now I'm going to remove this barcode sticker just for the aesthetics of the printer, as well as the screen protector. Finally, we'll remove the sheet of paper on top of the printer bed, because now yes, we have finished the assembly of the Artillery Genius Pro. I'm also going to remove the stickers on the print bed. It seems like they are quality control pass stickers and we don't need them anymore. Final step before plugging in the power cable would be to make sure that you have selected the proper voltage according to your region. I am in Spain, so it's set to 230 volts. If you live in Europe, you will probably have to do the same. And if you live in the United States, you will probably have to select 110 volts. Once done, I'm going to plug in the power cable and click the on switch. Having a look from the front, when we press the power button, the printer will beep and the touch screen will light up with the Artillery logo.
The next step will be to start with the bed leveling assistant. We'll only need to configure it once, since the printer has a bed leveling sensor similar to the BL Touch that will automatically do the mesh bed leveling for us. We're gonna go through the bed leveling process in a moment, but before I'm gonna talk to you about the sponsor of the video, PCBWay. PCBWay is your website to get your PCB prototypes the easy way. Thanks to PCBWay, you can get your own prototypes made in a very short time for a very competitive price. You can use their PCB Instant Quote tool to select in between a huge variety of options, layers, thicknesses, colors, materials, and more. Especially now, you can enjoy a $5 welcome bonus for your first order. Don't miss this opportunity and go check out their online store at PCBWay.com.
Alright, so according to the instructions, we'll have to go to Tools, Heat, and we'll set the E1 temperature to 240 degrees. Also, we'll set the bed to 70 degrees Celsius. Now we will have to wait till the target temperature is reached. This is real-time footage, and as you can see, it's heating up pretty fast compared to other printers I have in my farm. Once the target temperatures are ready, we'll go back and we'll go to Tools, Level, and we'll start leveling each of the corners one by one, as we always do using a sheet of paper. So we'll click the first point, and the printer will move to the bottom left corner. Here, we'll adjust the height using the wheel underneath. Then repeat with the second point, third, fourth. And I'm going to make a second round just to make sure it's perfectly leveled. Once we have double checked all the corners, we'll go to the fifth that is right in the middle. Then we'll go back to the home screen, and we're going to click on more, auto level. As you can see, the printer will start the mesh bed leveling process with the BL Touch sensor. Once it finishes with the last point, we'll insert the USB drive included with the printer and we'll click on print. As you can see, we have the preloaded G-codes included in the drive. I am going to print this cube file to check out what it is. As you can see, the printer is displaying an error and it's beeping. And that's because, as it says, filament detection switch is not pressed. And yeah, I forgot to insert the filament in place. So that's what we're gonna do now. So we'll confirm, stop the print, confirm, and we'll go to Tools, Change, and press the button In. We'll go to the top of the printer and insert the filament through the sensor, and then insert it through the direct drive extruder just like so. Once done, in the screen, we'll click In and wait till the filament starts coming out of the nozzle, as you can see here. Once done, we'll go back to Print, Cube, and the printer will automatically start printing the example G-code file once the temperatures are ready. So after a very little time, it started the print. I'm removing this excess filament that is hanging from the nozzle, and as you can see, the print started. I think the nozzle is too close to the print bed, so I'm adjusting the height of the print bed on the go, tightening the wheels at the bottom. As you can see in this footage, the printer is extremely quiet in every single axis, and the print position for now looks very good. As you can see, it has a light near the extruder, which allows us to perfectly see the print while it's being made, and the print bed is insulated from the bottom. I think it's the first printer of my fleet that has this feature. As you can hear, even the fans are not too loud as it uses to happen in all my other printers. The direct drive extruder provides a very high precision, especially in the retractions and displacements of the print head if we compare it to Bowden extruders. And the filament spool is perfectly holding on top of the printer as it should. Looks like the print has finished. And as you can see, in the brim it made on the first layer, the extruder was too close to the print surface, issue that I corrected on the go. But the overall quality of the print is actually very good. The walls are very consistent and the tube is looking pretty good too. As you can see in the screen, the print took 36 minutes, and if we go back, we can see that it is actually cooling down. The print bed is still at 51 degrees. We should have waited until it cools down to ambient temperature to remove the print. But we just have no time to make the video, and that's why I removed it with a spatula.
Alright guys, so overall the Artillery Genius Pro is what looks like a very good 3D printer that has obviously evolved a lot from the initial Prusa i3 style 3D printers. It features very good and silent motor drivers, a bottom insulated heated bed with a very cool texture on top to improve the adherence of our prints. It also has dual Z-axis motors and a direct drive extruder. All that together with a mesh bed leveling sensor that will make the automatic mesh bed leveling for us, and more cool features. I'm pretty happy with it, and I'm gonna print a couple more objects to see the quality of the prints. Alright, so here I have the original test cube that I printed before. And I've printed two new models, one is the Eiffel Tower and a little figurine. I have used the included black PLA filament, and if we have a closer look, we can see, especially in the Eiffel Tower, that the print is quite hairy. I have to say that I didn't use their included Cura file on the SD card, and I created a new profile in Cura Slicer, but the quality in this other figurine is frankly very good. It has almost no hairs, and the smoothness of this piece is fantastic. Alright guys, so if you're interested in knowing more about this printer and more, please smash the like button, subscribe to the channel, and leave a lot of comments down below. Finally, I want to give a huge shout out to our Patreon supporters for making all this possible. Please consider joining them to support the channel as well. And guys, see you in the next video.